Hello friends, this video on Matter and Magnetism Part 16 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Please make sure that you have watched all the videos till Part 15 before going ahead with Part 16. So the problem 1 says that a magnetic needle free to rotate in a vertical plane parallel to the magnetic meridian has its north tip pointing down at 22 degree with the horizontal. So let us suppose this is our earth. So there is a magnetic needle which is free to rotate in the vertical plane. Okay, so that means it is free to rotate like this. Now parallel to the magnetic meridian has its north tip pointing down at 22 degree with the horizontal. That means the needle is pointing down 22 degree with the horizontal. So this angle is 22 degrees. The horizontal component of the Earth's magnetic field at the place is known to be 0.35 Gauss. That means at this point, the Earth's horizontal magnetic field is known to be 0.35 Gauss, which is equal to 0.35 into 10 to the power minus 4 Tesla. Right? And what is this angle? This angle is nothing but your angle of inclination, or what we know as magnetic dip, because this is the angle which it makes with the horizontal surface of the earth, right? It makes 22 degrees with the horizontal. So this is your angle of magnetic dip. So you have to calculate the magnitude of the earth's magnetic field at that place. That means we have to calculate the value of B. So what do we know? Horizontal, according to definition of horizontal component of the earth, it is nothing but B cos I, right? So from here, we can directly calculate B as HE divided by cos I, which comes out to be 0.35 into 10 to the power minus 4 divided by cos 22 degrees. Now, cos 22 is found to be 0.9272. So this value comes out to be 0.38 into 10 to the power minus 4 Tesla, or we can write it as 0.38 Gauss. So this is the value of the Earth's magnetic field at that place. So to solve such kind of problems related to Earth's magnetism, that is related to the magnetic elements of the Earth, the best thing is to draw a rough diagram and understand what values are given in the problem. Because most of the time people have problem in understanding the question. So let us look at the next problem, which says that a short bar magnet has a magnetic moment of 0.48 joule per Tesla. That means the magnetic moment is given as 0.48 joule per Tesla. Give the direction and magnitude of the magnetic field produced by the magnet at a distance of 10 centimeters from the center of the magnet on the axis, the equatorial lines of the magnet. That means, let us suppose you have a bar magnet like this. Let us say these are the two poles of the magnet. So you have to calculate the magnetic field that is produced by the magnet at a distance of 10 centimeters from the center of the magnet. This is the center of the magnet. From here, you have to calculate the magnetic field at some point, let us say P, which is at a distance of 10 centimeters from the center of the magnet, and it lies on the axis. So in part A, we have to calculate the magnetic field at point P. So how do we calculate the magnetic field? We know that the axial magnetic field is given by mu naught by 4 pi into 2m divided by d cube, right? This is the same expression as we have for a solenoid, right? So we will use the same expression for a bar magnet because they both are similar. So in this, we can say m is given as 0.48, and what is d? D is the distance of the point from the center of the magnet, which is given as 10 centimeters. So mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. This divided by 4 pi into 2 into 0.48 divided by d is 10 into 10 to the power minus 2 whole cube. So this 4 pi and 4 pi will get cancelled. So this value comes out to be 9.6 into 10 to the power minus 5 Tesla. So this is the magnitude. And what about the direction of the axial magnetic field? Obviously, inside the magnet, the magnetic field lines are from south to north pole. So when we calculate the magnetic field at this point, the magnetic field will be along this direction. So this will be along SN. So the magnetic field will be from south to north pole, right? And even outside, the magnetic field lines are from north, they always originate from north pole. So this would be the direction of B axial. Now in the second part, it asks us to calculate the magnetic field at a point which is on the equatorial lines, that is normal bisector of the magnet. That means the point lies somewhere here. Let us call this point as Q. So this distance will again be 10 centimeters, and it says to calculate the magnetic field at this point. So even in this case, we will apply the expression for B equatorial, which is mu naught by 4 pi into M by D cube. So I have not derived this expression for a magnet. These expressions are derived for a solenoid, and the same applies to a bar magnet as well. So this mu naught by 4 pi is 10 to the power minus 7. And what is M? M is, in this case, it will be 0.48. And D is again 10 centimeters, that is 10 into 10 to the power minus 2 to whole cube. So this comes out to be 4.8 into 10 to the power minus 5 Tesla. So this is the magnitude of the magnetic field at the equatorial point. Now what would be the direction here? Now if you look at it, the direction in this case would be like this. Now because of this north pole, what would be the direction? The direction of the field lines is from north to, it originates from the north. So it will be somewhat like this. What would be the direction due to this south pole? Now in case of south pole, the magnetic field lines comes towards the south pole. So it would be like this. So the net magnetic field at point Q would be somewhere here. The resultant of these two magnetic fields, this is due to north pole and this would be due to south pole. So that net equatorial magnetic field would be along this direction. So we will say this would be along parallel direction to NS. That is, this is parallel to north-south direction, right? So this is how we calculate the axial and equatorial magnetic field due to a bar magnet, right? Okay. So let us go ahead and solve some more problems. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thank you once again.